I had a friend ask me recently, I was in Amsterdam, he's like, hey man, do you wanna do mushrooms? I'm like, no, I don't wanna do mushrooms. What? Mushrooms are for when you're 19 years old and you're in your parents' basement and you eat mushrooms and you're like, oh, I'm on the back of a dragon, yippee, I hope I get into college. Not when you're in your 30s. That's when your taxes crawl out of a bin and they're like, and he wanted me to do mushrooms because I was in Amsterdam. No, you don't do drugs around the Dutch. Dutch people are weirdos sober. Have you met Dutch people? Ooh, have you seen my wooden shoes? Really? Wooden shoes. They make Nikes, asshole. Like, seriously. But windmills? Why do you know what a windmill does? I thought it made potato chips, but they're everywhere. Just hanging out. And have you heard them speak? That language is ridiculous. Like, oof, doop de boop, smiggity boop. That's seriously smiggity boop. That's like a Dutch guy offering you an apple. Oof, doop, smiggity boop. Really? That's the word you chose? I had an epiphany recently. I don't want to brag. I had an epiphany. It has to do with the fact that, ladies, you have something, you're lucky. Because you don't have a certain thing that we all have as guys. And I just realized this. I just realized it. You don't have a touch-it voice. You know what I'm talking about? The touch it voice. Guys know what I'm talking about. There's a voice in your head that shows up when you reach an age, like around maybe 12, and it just starts going, touch it, 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 touch it. You should really touch it, touch it, touch it now, touch it, touch it, touch it, touch it, touch it. You can see kids almost thinking it sometimes. There's like, touch it, touch it. It's there till we die. It's there. That voice never leaves, by the way. It's there till, hey, beep, beep. You touch it, and then you're out. It just gets progressively slower through life. That's just a fact. You know what I'm like, sir, you're a little bit older than I am, but it's still there. You're just more like, hey, veg. But anyway, I'm a classy guy. So, I remember so vividly the first time a lady touched my penis. She wasn't a lady, first of all. She was a girl. She was a woman. Lady. She had long gloves on. She's like, I'm going to touch your penis now. She had little glasses on a stick. Let's take a look for the penis touchery. And anyways, she took me up to we went up to this cave by her house because that's the only place she would let, you know, it happen. That's really good for your self-esteem. I'll touch it, but only in a cave. Oh, this won't scar me. And so we went up into the cave. And she touched it. Nothing magical, she just touched it. And it was amazing. Like the nipples opened up and little cuckoo birds shot out going, cuckoo, 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 and fireworks shot out of my ass. And I was like, this is amazing. I've got to touch her. That's what I've got to do. So I reached out and I just touched it. Touch. That's it, that's all I did, by the way. Nothing, boom. Like I'm push starting a Prius. I touched it, and then I stood there, just like a fat kid ruining a cake. You ever look in somebody's eyes and realize you're sharing one of the most disappointing moments in their life? What the hell are you doing? And that's when I realized that ladies don't have the touch it voice. Just touching it isn't enough for you. You need people to touch it while whistling, while burning incense and humming weird things. There's proof, guys. Go home tonight and flick your lady in the, just bang, like that. And she'd be like, what the hell are you doing? But if she flicks you, you'd be like, ouch, what, are you flirting with me? What? Thank you so much, Montreal. It has been a pleasure, as always.